Hey guys, how are we? It's a beautiful evening. Fall's starting to set in. Getting nice and some good temperatures around here, so I'm not cooking in the garage. Well, we're not directly going to work on the Manx tonight, and we're not going to work on the Model A. We are going to have some fun with some tools, though. All right? I'll show you what we're going to do.
Yeah, it looks like a mess back here. But see that and that? Those are generic hoops. Those are going to be the roll cage on the dune buggy. But they're not the right size. They're a little wide in areas. Angles aren't exactly right. So we've got to fix them. I don't really feel like cutting them unless I have to. I don't want to narrow them in the middle. So what else can we do? That's where this guy comes in. This is a JD squared Model 3 bender. There we go, right there. Get a little promo. This is a really nice handheld bender. You bolt it to your floor and you go through, you clamp your pipe in here, in your die. Right, put your pipe in your die, clamp it down, and then ratchet action. Using ratchet action, you crank it and it bends your pipe. Problem is, one, it's a lot of work for 1¾-inch chrome moly. Two, I really don't want to drill holes in my floor. There are options though, and it's sitting right there on the table. Swag Off-Road makes this really cool kit where you can convert this thing from manual to hydraulic. So for this conversion, use the Swag Off-Road kit, which includes some brackets, some bolts, some hardware, and this really cool two-piece coupling kit, which I bought unfinished, unwelded, welded up my corners, and hit it with some really cool paint that I had bought for some wheels at some point, and didn't end up using on wheels, so it kind of looks like candy red. It's kind of cool looking. All right, got this. The other critical component comes from our friends at Harbor Freight, and it is a 8-ton long ram round body hydraulic jack. I don't think that they sell this one in the store anymore. You can get it in other places, but it's an air over hydraulic jack. Plug it into your air hose off your compressor, and it does your hydraulic work for you with air power. I don't even have to use the Armstrong method anymore on this, guys. We're gonna use air. We're gonna, just easily, a chuck, and boom, you're going. Part number on this, like I said, I don't think Harbor Freight carries this anymore, but the Harbor Freight part is 56215. I found this on Facebook Marketplace a few months ago, and it's new old stock. I open it up and it's brand new. It's never even been taken out of the plastic. This part goes here. This is gonna face down. This will sleeve right in there. I'm so bright my parents call me son, guys. Really? I'm gonna get a little piece of wood to prop that up on so it's balanced. Sits right in there, right like that. This goes over the top, just like that. These bolts go down through, just like that. The washer on the top, the washer on the bottom, and then the nylon lock nut. Thank you. let's tighten that down to 70 foot-pounds. Step it up to 70, do 50 to start. It's 50. Always take the pressure back off your torque wrench. Safely store it away back in its home. So it's ready for you next time you need to use it. Always torque your lug nuts on your cars, guys. Never want that wheel passing you on the highway. All right. Now, there are some certain parts that we take off of this guy that we're not going to need anymore. First and foremost, is this. We're not going to need this arm anymore. So we go ahead and take that guy off. Bring it back. Still got you? Okay. Just had to move the camera a little bit because I had to get a socket. It was underneath you. All right. So take that nut off the bottom. And we're going to take this part right out the top. Set that in there so we don't lose it. I'm going to take this stuff off for the moment, because I think I have to disassemble this piece off. Set that off the side. The whole thing's gonna come loose here. Yep, there it is. Bang. Don't worry, everybody's okay. Nobody died. All right, now we take our new piece, spin it around so we can work with it. All right, now we take this guy and we set it in here. Using our handy dandy pin, set it off to the side. And this guy goes down like this. So that's right in there. Bingo bongo. Still a little heavy on one side, so be careful. Don't let it fall over. Tighten it down so it's snug. All right, now our ram hooks to our other leg, which we're going to go ahead and put back on. So change your perspective a little bit. The last piece we need to do for this setup is we hooked it up to the shop air. We're going to extend the ram a little bit because we need to put the hole in the ram into this sleeve. All right. So we can go ahead and loosen that sleeve up. That should be another 19. And this guy up. We won't use that collet anymore. We use this collet. Yep. And our bolt. All right. So we have a bolt, and they provide us with a collet to go through. That collet anymore because it doesn't go in there. This collet goes in through here. There we go. Get that sleeve in there. Put our bolt back down through. There we go, through to the bottom. Nice and tight on that collet. Put our nut back on there with our washer. We can tighten that up. We'll tighten this guy back up. What we've done through this conversion is made this thing fully air over hydraulic. So all we have to do is push our little lever here. And it will extend out our arm. So we don't have to use the Armstrong method anymore. We don't have to get worn out. And as long as you keep it balanced, we don't even have to bolt this thing to the floor. I'd probably recommend putting some weight on there. I've got an old piece of Anvil railroad rail that I'll probably put on the base. But you can put your material in here, keep it balanced. You know, if you've got a long piece, make sure you use a runout table or something like that. But now you can put, you can clamp your material into the die, have your appropriate size die. I've got a 1-inch die in here right now, down here in the box, down on the ground, that brown box, that guy. I've got the 1¾-inch die. So all you gotta do, squeeze your handle. There you go. Now, that's not even the coolest part yet, guys, because here's the end of it. Here's the coolest part. Is this guy. Here's a toughie, all right? So, what now? What do I do now? It's out. How do I retract it? What do I do? Come on, what do I do, guys? Basically, you're using a big elastic band and it'll retract this guy. So let's get that installed. All right, so the last little bit is getting this nice elastic band and it hooks around your front pin. So I loosen that up. Slid it in there. We use a lot of force because this thing's strong. This elastic is really strong, really tight. Had the boy holding on to one side and braced this end up against something and pulled that elastic band and I put it through a bolt here in the round end. It's perfect. It'll help us retract it because now I don't have to try and force that pipe back. So watch. You got your bend in your pipe. Now you want to release it. You know, you release your bolt at the other end. Let's release our pressure on our handy little guy that's over our release valve. Nice and easy. And that elastic pulls it back. Look at that. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy, guys. This is perfect. Now, this guy is perfect. It's exactly what we need. But the nice thing is, I don't own this bender. This belongs to my uncle. It's on long-term loan from the Dennis Moore collection. Thanks, Uncle Dennis. He let me borrow it for the roll cage. And I'm going to improve it. And all this stuff is just bolt-on, so you can always take it back off and put the other stuff back on. But when I take this bender back to Uncle Dennis, not only is he going to get the original bender back with the bar and the ratchet mechanism, he gets the air over hydraulic, and he's also going to get the 1¾-inch die. So he gets all the parts back from it. Look, if you're going to borrow a tool from somebody, you better return it back with some extra consumables. Your buddy lets you borrow his reciprocating saw or the Sawzall, you better buy him another pack of blades when you take that thing back. If you use the living daylights out of it, you've had it for a while, if it's a battery-powered one, go buy him a new battery, all right? If you use a living daylights out of that battery, you better give him a new battery, all right? Treat your friends nice, and they're going to treat you nice. They're going to be there to back you up. But guys, that's it. This is perfect. This is exactly what we need. Really easy air over hydraulic setup. When I'm ready, all I do is switch out my die. So this, take this 1-inch die, and I put the 1¾-inch die that's in the box. And we're ready to fire this thing up. Take some of that roll cage material that's over there behind the boy. There it is. Hide in the corner. And we're going to bend it up so it fits on that dune buggy. So just as an idea, hoop behind the windshield. Hoop behind the seats. They're going to be tied in with crossbars beside the seats if I can
fish them in there. It's going to be pretty tight. And crossbars down the top. And then I'm going to have down bars coming down here, down through the body, behind the back, beside the back seat. And I'm going to rig up a structure to support underneath that back seat. And probably tie it back to this bar somehow. Because that should reinforce my cage. That should reinforce my strength. Everything's going to be double plated on both sides of the chassis. So it'll be nice and strong. I'll probably have a crossbar up there in the front underneath the dashboard. You know, knee bar down there. Figure out what I need to do up there.
But guys, that's it for tonight. You got to keep working. Do what you need to do. Work the tools. Use your tools. Hey, and you end up with a fun toy. We're going to take this guy out. It's official. It's got tags. We're ready to run it on the roads. And we're going to enjoy this thing. It's going to be a beautiful week this week. So maybe one night this week, we'll take it out, go get some ice cream. I don't have seatbelts in it yet, so I don't want to go too far. But we can get up around the corner with this guy. All right, guys. Take care of yourselves and take care of someone else. I'll see you next time. Bye.